Hello friends, welcome back to Oracle DB online training. So in today's session we will be looking at how to apply the latest patch which is on if your database is running on 19.11 and you want to upgrade your database to 19.12. For that we will be going to apply the latest patch on the existing version, and this will be upgrade from 19.11 to 19.12. and before we begin further, I'll request all the new friends to please subscribe my YouTube channel. On this platform you are already getting a lot of learnings like how to install the database, how to upgrade the database, how to apply any latest patches, Golden Gates related stuffs, and apart from that data guard related stuffs. So even though we have covered the OEM and various performance tuning topics that we are covering so far, and if you have any question or if you want to take the personal training, you can get in touch with me on this contact details. So without wasting much time, we will start the session and we'll look at how to perform these operations. So now this is my current environment. So basically this is two node production setup, and same we have the two node standby database also, which is up and running. Okay, these are standby one, standby two instances, and this is my prod one and prod two instance, and you can see that there is a no gap as of now. So what we'll do, we'll first apply the latest patch on the standby, and then later we'll be applying the same patch on the production setup. So these are the patches that is required for the July 21 patch. I already downloaded, and this is the latest OPatch utility that is going to be required. So I have already transferred on the server, and I have already updated the OPatch utility, as well as I unzip this patch on my this location U01 app latest U01 latest patch location, and these are the file I already unzipped it, and after that I just I have prepared all these steps that is required for this process. So what I'll do, I'll just start this process one by one, and you can keep on watching till the end so that you can understand how to apply the patches if you have the standby database and production database also. So first we'll applying the patch on standby, later we'll be applying the same patch on the production setup. Okay, so basically I have just taking the pre-checks or before performing the patching. So you can see that MRB process is up and running. So what we can do, we can transfer this patch on the standby 2, and this will be happening in the rolling manner, rolling patch. Okay, so that means we are applying the first patch on the standby 1, and later we'll be applying on the standby 2, that is my second node. Okay, so after that we can verify the existing patches also by logging to the grid as well as the database home. I'll just be on mute, I'll perform these operation quickly. So before we will be doing the patching, we will be doing some pre-checks like this, verifying the invalid objects. After that we will be looking for the conflict checks, and then we will be applying the actual patches. Okay, so without wasting much time, I'll first quickly do these changes. So here you can see that my existing version is 19.11, and so these are basically as a pre-checks we are performing. Okay, after that I need to basically verify from the DB home also these values, and then we'll be verifying the invalid object counts. So now this verification is almost done on the Oracle Home. Okay. So here we have canceled the recovery on the first node, and after that I started it on from the second node. Okay, that means if you have the rack standby database, you can stop the recovery on one of the nodes and start it from the other nodes. So this is my node one. I stopped the recovery and started it from the standby node two. Okay, so that means we don't have to worry about the recovery part also during the time of patching. The next thing that we need to verify is patch config. So this is the command that I already copied and made the plan of action according to the patch which I already downloaded. This is the latest patch that we are applying. So first we'll be verifying the patch config on the standby database, and after that we'll be doing for the grid home also we'll be verifying the patch config, and then we can proceed further. Okay, so in database we will be applying the two release updates. After that we'll be applying the OJVM patches also. So I'll just copy these commands, be ready with commands when we can verify the opatch config. So patch config we can verify on the RDBMS home as well. So the order of fetching will be standby node 1, after that standby node 2, then prod 1, prod 2, like that. Okay. Guys, if you want to learn how to apply the patches using the Opatch Auto utility, you can refer my previous videos. I already covered how to perform the patch using Opatch Auto utility. Without much intervention of users, you can directly perform. I mean, we can perform the patching without much intervention, and that's very simple process. You can refer my previous video. So this is basically a manual patching step where we are performing all the steps manually one by one. Okay, so now we can see that almost all the patches there is no conflict. That means we can proceed further. So after this, we have to basically verify the system check, space check. For that, we need to basically make one text file. And after that, we need to run this command that is to check the system space, both in the grid home as well as for the DB home. So we'll first make the file in that from the grid home, and after that we'll do the same thing for the DB home, and we'll run these commands to verify whether there is sufficient space available or not. Okay. So here we can see that grid related system check has been passed. That means there is sufficient space on the mount point related to grid home, and same thing we are verifying for the RDBMS home as well. So once these checks are done, then we can directly go ahead with a database stop. That is, for first we'll be stopping the node 1, and after that we'll be stopping the node 2. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll just copy the command, be ready with the steps so we can proceed further. This is my standby node. This is going to be the node name, and this is the file that you are going to use. Okay, and this will be my command for use to stop the home. That means all the database on this home will be stopped. So we are stopping the database home on the standby node 1, that is the standby 1 in our case. Okay, same thing you can do for your case also. So later while applying on the standby 2, I'll be using the standby 2 over there. Once this is over, then we can proceed with the root unlock command that is used to pre-patch command. Basically this needs to be executed from the root users. So first we'll verify whether there is a pmon. Yeah, so pmon has been stopped. That is our. So after that we will be executing the prepatch from the root user. I'll execute it. That means it will unlock the cluster. It will unlock the database cluster from the entire clusterware, and then we can proceed with patching of the standby node 1 grid as well as the database homes. So it will take within 1 or 2 minutes it will be over. Then after that we can proceed with the patching of the grid home and then patching of the database home. I'll be ready with all these commands so that we can apply the patches on the grid. So once this pre-patch executes, that means your cluster, everything will be down and it will be out of the entire cluster. That means it will be in the unlock phase. Okay. So this command is still executing. We have to just wait. It has to be successfully completed. So now we can see that it is almost done. Then after that we have to basically verify whether there is any services up and running or not. It shouldn't be generally. So now we are good to apply with the patches. So I'll apply the patches from, you can run these commands one by one, or you can directly paste all them or make a SSH file and execute them. Okay. So from the grid home, I need to execute these commands one by one. It will apply the patches one by one. So this detail, you can get it from the readme file also. Once you will unzip the file of a patch, you will get the readme file where you need to understand which patch you need to apply. Those details you can get it from there. So now these patches are getting applied. Meanwhile, we can open the logs also to get the details about them. Okay, so now in the backend we can see that there is patching which is happening. So as of now my standby 2 is still running. You can verify the details from here. So currently only standby 2 is running. That means you don't have to take the downtime also for doing this patching activities. So we'll wait for a few minutes. After that, once this patches is over, then we can proceed with the standby 2, and later we can proceed with the prod 1 and prod 2. So meanwhile, if you guys haven't subscribed my YouTube channel, please subscribe. And if you have any question so far, you can mention me in the comment box. I'll definitely try to help you out. I hope this is helpful. Even though you can from if you are your database is base version like 19.5, 19.3. So 19.3 is basically base version. If you are on that version, if you want to upgrade, wanted to upgrade it from 19.3 to 19.12, then also you can use this method. Even though if you are on the some other versions like 19.10 or 19.5 or 19.8, so from there also you can upgrade it to 19.12 using the same patch, same method that you need to follow. Okay. So first apply are you I think this patch is basically a release update. So once this patch is over, then after that other three patches will all also be in line. They will be also applied. Then after that we have to do the verification part, and then we can go ahead with a database apply the patch methods. Okay. So as a preparation, you have to basically make sure that your plan of action is ready before you go with a patching activity. So in the back end, all these steps are happening. We can just monitor for a few minutes, and after that this patch will be over. Okay. Now we can see that one of the patches successfully applied. Now it is going with the second patch in the list. That is, we have started this one. 6816 patch is still applying. So these patches will not take much time. The first one has taken time because there are a lot of subcomponents to be patched, and now this patch will basically take another 5 minutes of time. Meanwhile, I'll take the video pause, and once this patch is over, then we can verify and then start with a database patches. Okay. So guys, we can see that we have successfully applied all these patches. Now last patch is going on with a grid environment. It should not take much time from here, and as soon as this will finish, we'll be verifying the patch on the grid home. After that, we can go ahead with database home patches. Okay. So so this is over. Now we can verify the latest patch detail which is applied on the grid home. And after that, I'll log into the Oracle users, and I'll just execute these commands. Okay. So here we can see that these are the latest patch that we have applied as of now. And this is 19.12 version, which was previously 19.11. Okay. So grid home patching is over. Now I'll be going ahead with the Oracle users home patching. So before that, we have to execute pre-patch, which is there from the file we have already copied. And let me just try to apply the patches of Oracle database home one by one. So I just paste all the commands. It will apply the patch on the DB home. Okay, it will take another 5 minutes. As we can see that almost all the patches on the database home is completed. So once this is over, then we are going to apply the OJVM patch from the database home location. So as you can see, this patch is applied successfully. Now I'll apply the OJVM patch on the database home. So let me just copy this patch and apply it on the RDBMS home. So guys, OJVM patch is successfully applied. Now I'll verify the patch detail as well as then I'll perform the post patch activities. So I'll copy the command from here. I'll execute on the RDBMS home on the standby one, that is my node one. Okay, so first we'll verifying the patch details. After that will be, so these patches are latestly just applied just now. Here we can see it is 19.12 version of the patch which is applied on the database release update. And after that we can run the post patch command from the RDBMS home. Okay, so let me just execute it. This is successfully applied. After that I need to execute some commands from the root user, that is root add RDBMS and the root crs.sh file. Both has to be executed from the root user on the standby one, that is node one in our case. Okay, so post patch basically it will start the CRS services and it will lock the this node cluster into the entire clusterware. After that we have to start the database home, that is standby node one related database which we have previously bring down. That means standby instance will be started. First instance will start and after that we will be verifying the details. Okay guys, now this post patch from root CRS post patch is successfully completed and now I can start the database home from the Oracle user. So I'll log into the Oracle user and I execute this command. It will bring up my database instance. Okay, so let me just start the database instance first on the stand node one. So the patching on the node one is successfully completed. Now we can verify the status of all the patches, and after that we can proceed with the patching on the second node. So before proceeding the patching on second node, we have to stop the MRP over there, and we'll start the MRP from the first instance. And so we can see that this patch is successfully applied on the node one. And the same thing we can verify for Oracle user as well. Okay, I'll execute command from Oracle home also, so that we can verify all the details. So, and I'll stop the recovery on the second node. I'll start it from the first node. So now we can proceed with the standby 2 patching. So we'll follow the all steps that we have followed on the node 1. So let me just start from this starting point. So I'll cover up all so we'll not do this conflict check, so because we have already verified from the node 1. This is best practice to follow, like you can perform the conflict check, but I'll not do this step because already I know all these are perfect. So we can directly go ahead with the stop of database home, and after that we can start with the root CRSP check activity. Okay, so I'll do that quickly. So my database instance is down. I can proceed with the root CRS prepatch execution. So I'll just copy the command, execute it from the root. So guys, CRS cluster is down and pre-patch execution has been completed. Now I created one SH file for applying the patch on the grid home. These patches are already copied on this location. I'll just execute this SH file and we can see. Okay. So now we can say that 19.12 patch is successfully applied on the grid home. So now we have to proceed with a RDBMS patching, that is from here. Okay, first we'll execute the pre-patch. After that, we'll apply the RDBMS home patches and then OGVM patches. After that, I'll run the postpatch.sh from the RDBMS home. Okay, so I'll make one SH file and execute it from the Oracle users. So basically, I just modify this permission for oui-patch.xml file. So if you don't modify this permission, so while applying the RDBMS home patch, you might face some issue. So in order to avoid that, once you invoke this patching activity on the DP home, make sure that this permission has to be 660. And that is, other user can also read and write on this file. Okay, so I just modify that permission and now I'm executing the patch on the RDBMS home. So it should successfully complete. Once this is over, then we can start our clusterware and everything like that. Okay. So the first patch is almost over on the RDBMS home. We can see that this is from the Oracle home that we have executed this patch, and one SH file that we have created, we are successfully applied that patch, and after that it will automatically apply the second patch in the list, that is going to be this patch 816, and after that we'll apply the OGVM patch. So everything is in the SH file, we will just execute it. And after that, we will verify and run the post-patch script from the RDBMS home. Once this step will be over, then we can execute the root sh files. Root add RDBMS.sh and root crs post-patch command. So as soon as our standby database patching is completed, we'll apply the same patches on the production side. Okay. So I hope you guys are enjoying this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel if you are new on this YouTube channel. And also, if you think that this is a useful video for you, please like this video and share across all your friend circle. So recently we have completed 1000 subscriber also. Thank you guys for supporting me. That's a very good feeling. And keep watching guys. On this platform you are getting a lot of learnings. So in future also I'm going to make a lot of such videos so that all the DBA don't have to worry about any questions, any things. So guys, we can see all the 19.12 patches successfully applied on the DB home from the Oracle users. So now we can proceed with a root script execution from the root user. Okay, those post patch is also done from the Oracle home. Now I'll be executing this command from the root users. From the root user, we need to execute. So guys, now we can see the post patch is successfully applied and this is changed to normal state, and this is my current patch level, and this is completely successfully completed. That means our patching on node 2 is also done, and with this our standby side patching is successfully completed. Now we can do the some post patch activities like verifying the cluster details and everything. So I'll execute this command one by one. From the root user also we can execute, or from other user also we can execute. Let me just execute from the root where only. So I'll execute these queries one by one. So here you can say the ESMS instance is up and running, and the listener services are also running d.bin, and even the cluster status we can verify from here. and patch status is currently normal. So that means we have successfully applied the patch on. Now we have to start the database instance also. That is a database home which we have stopped earlier. So this is for standby one. Let me copy the same command for standby two also. I'll just mention this as standby two. Okay. From the Oracle user, I need to execute the same command in order to start the database instance. So I'll fire this query. So now we can see that both my standby one and standby two instance are up and running, and the patching is successfully completed on both grid as well as RDBMS homes. Even though we can run the OPatch LS inventory queries also for verifying the patch details on both grid as well as Oracle home. Okay. So once the successful standby patching is over, then we can go ahead with the production side patching with the same steps. Okay. And at the end of this entire activity, we have to execute the data patch verbose on the production side only from this location. So I'll start with the production side patching now. So guys, we'll start with the patching on production database. So first we'll, this, you can see that the archive apply is happening and there is a no lag between the primary and standby database. So what I'll do, I'll start the patching from so pre-check part I'll not do on the production side. So as a best practice, you should always follow this conflict check and everything. So once you will do a conflict check, then after that you can go ahead with the database stop step. So you need to log in from the Oracle home user and stop the database. So I'll stop the first instance by executing this command. So it will stop my prod one instance from the entire clusterware. After completing this step, I'll start the patching. So I'll execute root CRA dot prepatch from the root user so that my cluster will be unlocked. So parallelly, we can see the alert log as well. So instance one database is down. And as of now, our standby database, both the instances are up and running. And remember, guys, we are applying the latest 19.12 patch on both grid as well as RDBMS home, including my rack primary database and rack standby database. So we have started from the rack standby and we successfully completed, and now we are trying to apply the patches on the rack production setups. So first node we are doing this activity, and later we will be doing on the second node. So you can see that only ASM instance is up and running. So after that I need to unlock the root home by executing this prepatch command so that this command execution can be monitored through the logs also. And once this is over, then we will be proceeding with a patching activity that is either from the grid or the RDBMS home. So I'll first apply the grid home patch, which I already mentioned as a .sh file. And after that, it will verify also. So I'll show you how to perform those tasks one by one. Okay. So this is currently unlocking my grid infrastructure from the entire clusterware. And so currently we can see this is in normal state. So once your grid is unlocked, so it will change to rolling patch. That means we are applying the patches on the rolling manner. That means my second node instance will not be affected due to this issue. So if you log into the database on the second instance, you can see the instance is up and running successfully. Okay. So I need to just log in and execute the db command so that I can verify. I think this command is not available here. I'll transfer it from some other nodes. So you can see that my second instance is only up and running. This is read write mode, and here it is. This is successfully unlocked from the node one. So you can cross verify the PMON details and other steps. So as of now, there is no services up and running. Okay, now I'll log into the grid user and try to patch the grid home. So you can patch either of them, like RDBMS home or grid home. There is no issue with that. So let us try with our first database home, and we'll try to do the patching of the cluster home later. So in order to patch, we'll already have the script that is DB home. So let me just check DB underscore patch dot sh file I already created. So I'll execute this file. So in the backend, it is just doing all the activities, like it is performing the patching. So we can monitor the log also while these patches are getting applied on the home. So this is going to take a little bit of time. Meanwhile, we can be on. We can take a little bit of pause here, and once this patching successfully completes, then I'll let you the other details. Okay. So I hope you are understanding how this process goes, and if you have any query regarding this patching or how to upgrade the patching activity, how to upgrade any database from 19.11 to 19.12, you can follow these steps. If you have any queries, you can definitely get in touch with me. Remember, guys, we haven't applied data patch verbose on any one of the nodes as of now. Once our entire patching is completed, then we will be applying on the production side. So by logging to any one of the existing database instance. Okay. So guys, now the RDBMS patch is successfully completed on the production side. So now next step will be applying the patch on the grid home. So I'll log into the grid home, and after that I'll start the patching on the grid home. So for that I need to log in from grid home, and here I need to run the ls-lrt command. There is a sh file that I'll already pasted here. So I'll use this grid-patch.sh file. Simply, I just execute the grid SS file. Okay, it will start the patching on the grid home of the prod one, that is my node one in this case. Okay. Parallelly, we can monitor the logs also. So as soon as this patching is over, then I'll discuss further. This will take another 5 to 10 minutes for applying the entire 4 different patches on the grid home. So 1, 2, 3, 4 patches will be applied on the grid home. So guys, we have successfully applied the patch on grid home, and this is you can see all these logs, and we have successfully applied the patches on the node 1 with 19.12 patch. After that, what we need to do is we have to just log into the root user and execute the two scripts, that is root add underscore rdbms.sh and root crs.sh with hyphen post patch commands. Okay, so I'll quickly log in into the root users. From there, I'll execute these two commands. So first command basically comes in seconds, milliseconds, and second one will take a little bit of time. So let me just open the logs also parallelly. So with this, it will start the ASM instance on the node 1. And after that, we need to start the database home that we have previously stopped. Okay, so it is basically starting the clusterware services, and once this is over, then we can go ahead with further steps on the patching on the second node. Okay, so I hope you guys are understanding how this patching, or you can say database version upgrade from the 19.11 to 19.12 is working. So even though these same steps can be used for upgrading from the 19.3 version to the 19.12, or even you can perform the same step for other versions like 19.5, 19.8 or 19.10 to 19.12, these steps will remain the same. The only thing that you need to take care during the patching is how you are going to perform the patching. Either you can use the manual patching method or you can use the auto patch method. So if you want to learn how to perform the auto patch method, you can refer my previous videos that I already created on those topics. So I have covered everything in the details in those videos. I'll provide the link in the description. Please go through. And if you have any queries regarding today's session or even the previous sessions, you can get in touch with me on my email ID. You can get it from the description box. Okay, so let us so I think this is starting the cluster, and we can see on the alert log in the logs also that it is executed the command crs. It will start crs-wait, that is still getting executed. Meanwhile, we can look for the ps-ef grep pmon as well as d.bin, that is for demand monitoring. So here we can see that it is still starting. So that's a So now this command execution is successfully completed, and we can proceed further with this. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll log into the Oracle home, and from there I'll execute the database startup command. So basically that will be my database home startup, which I already stopped previously. So I need to start with this command. So I'll just copy it and run from the Oracle home users. That is our Oracle users. From there, I'll executing this command. It will basically start my database instance in the background. So let me just open the alert log also. Yeah. So once my database instance on the first node is started, and then I can proceed with the patching on the second node. So in the alert log, we can clearly see that how the rebalancing operation happens and how all these things get changes. So now this is almost over, and after that I need to execute post patch activity, post verification, post patching the verification, that which will include all the patch details and everything. So this is, we can verify, and after that we can proceed for patching on the second node, that is prod 2. I will start with this step further. Okay, so now we can see that this database instance is now started, that is prod 1. I'll log in into the database and we can see the both my so here we can see that it is upgraded to 19.12. okay, and but we haven't applied the patch on the second instance, that is pending. So I'll start with that part now, and I'll first stop the second instance, and after that I'll start the patching. So for this I'll take one of the sessions from here and I'll start the patching activity right away. Okay, so let me just copy the command one more time. I hope you are understanding how the this things works in case of a RAG database. So previously we have seen same procedure for the standby. Now we are dealing with the production setups, that is my primary database instances. Okay, so let us this command execute successfully, then we'll start the patching. But before running the patching, we need to execute the root CRS, that is pre-patch, which will unlock my CRS from the entire cluster where stack. So I'll execute these queries. Okay, and after that we can either proceed with a grid patching or the RDBMS patching. In this case I'm starting with a RDBMS home patching first, and later I'll be patching the grid home. Okay, so let's wait for another 1 minute or so, and after that we can move further. Okay, so now my database instance is down. The next part that I need to do is execute the root CRS pre-patch command from the root user, so that we can unlock the cluster from the stack. Okay, so this is my second instance. Here I'll execute the tell command in order to monitor the same. So as soon as my pre-patch command executes successfully, I'll log into the Oracle home user, that is for RDBMS home patching. I'll start the patching on the RDBMS home. Okay. So guys, my locking of cluster is successfully completed from the by executing the pre-patch. Now I'll log into the Oracle user and try to execute the patches that I already transfer on the servers. So let me just run the ls-lrt command for db_patch.sh file. So this sh file will already have all the commands for patching. So this is not a best practice to follow, but yeah, you can do it if you have the testing environments like that. Okay, so now I'll started with the patching on the database home, and later we'll be doing the patching on the grid home. Okay, so you can do the patching on the grid first and after that RDBMS home, that's up to you, but I'm doing the patching for on the RDBMS home first and later on the grid home. Okay, so meanwhile we can check the alert logs also, log files also. This patching will take another 2 to 5 minutes of time, depend upon the your database size and all. Okay, so let us just wait for a few more minutes. Once this patching on the RDBMS is over, then we can go ahead with patching on the grid home. Okay. So guys, now the RDBMS home patching is completed, and I'll start with the patching of grid home. So I'll log into the grid home, and you can see this 19.12 patches are applied successfully on the DB home. So this is from the Oracle user. I need to execute the grid patching from the grid home. Okay, so here I just already pasted the grid. Grid patching command, so I'll execute it right away. So you can run this query in NewHub mode also. So if you are worrying about the PuTTY inactiveness, so you can directly execute in NewHub sh then grid patch dot sh, and at the end you need to put ampersand so that it will execute in the background. Okay, so now my patching on the grid home is running. So what I'll do, I'll just open the logs, and meanwhile we can keep on monitoring the sessions. It should not take much time from here. As soon as this is over, then I'll tell you what is the next step that we need to follow in order to complete the entire patching activity. Okay, so at last we have to just once everything is over, then basically we have to start the database, and before that we have to run the post patch root.crs.sh post patch, and after that we have to start the database home, which I have stopped on prod 2, and at the end we will doing the post patching verification. Once this is over, then we'll start with the data patch hyphen workflows from the opatch location. So I hope you are understanding how this patching process works and how you can upgrade from the previous version to the latest 19.12 version. And if you have any queries so far, you can mention me in the comment box. I'll definitely try to help you out. Okay. So we'll see how this patching proceeds from here. Okay, I'll just take the pause here, and I'll be back in 2 to 5 minutes as soon as this patching is over on the grid home. Okay, so now my patching on the grid home is successfully completed, and we can see that it is 19.12. so the next thing that we need to do is we have to basically run the root CRS commands. So these two commands I need to execute from the root users. So I'll log into the root user and execute these commands. So now my CRS services will come up, and cluster will become normal. And after that, we need to start the database home. So I'll be ready with the commands. Okay, so it will start my database home. I need to execute this command from the this startup command from the Oracle users. So once this is over, then I can proceed with the data patch verbose command. So meanwhile, we can look for the PMON processes of ASM and other steps. So if you want, you can monitor the log also for better understanding. So these errors can be ignorable. I will start your cluster in few minutes. So here we can see CRS, it will start CRS hyphen wait command has been executed in the backend, which will start my cluster where stack. Okay. So within a few seconds of time, it will start all the services. As soon as this command completes, we'll start the database instance on the second node, that is a prod2 instance. I hope you guys have understood how to perform this patching activity. So basically, I just have one so whenever you are doing the patching activity, and if you have the two node database, so make sure you verify the Quora inventory content.xml file directory. So in this directory, you need to basically verify the permission for all the homes like OUI and hyphen patch. This has to be matching with your node one or the first node where you have already performed the patching successfully. So sometimes due to the permission issues, you can face some challenges during the time of patching. So to avoid any issues before starting of the patching, you just make sure there is a sufficient permissions, like 660 is exist on all the files. Okay, otherwise you might be facing some challenges during the time of patching. So now we can see my cluster upgrade state has been changed to normal, and this is my patch level. That means we have successfully applied the patches on root as well as a grid home. Okay, so next part that I need to do is to start the database instance. So for that, I need to use srvctl-start home, and this is the home location. This is the file that I referred during the time of stop. So we'll start the database instance on the second instance. As of now, we can see that only first instance is running. So I'll start the second instance also. So whenever you are doing any activity, make sure your alert logs are open. It will help you to understand the background changes. Okay, so now my connected to Oracle user from here, I'll execute the start command. So it will start my database instance on the second node, that is prod2. So once the database home is started, that means you can proceed with the data patch hyphen verbose command that we are so from the first node, I'll execute this command. It will make the statistics up to date with the latest patch details. Okay, so my database on the node 2 is starting. So during the time of startup, you might face this errors in the views. So don't worry about that part. So now we can see my both the database instance are open. So second instance is still in mount state. It will automatically come into read write mode. So we just have to wait. So actually, there is a background process running. So now we can see the database instance is read write mode. So now I can go ahead and apply the latest patch. Okay, so here we can see that it is 19.12 version. So in order to execute the data patch verbose, you need to basically go to this path, that is opatch look directory. From here we can execute the data patch hyphen verbose. Okay, so now it is connected to the database and it will start the statistics update. So in the alert log we can see that opatch file present, and this is cleaning and refreshing the metadata. So it will take a few minutes more, and here we can see that it is updated to 19.12. So I think so it will successfully complete in few minutes of time. And if your database is bigger in size, so maybe that will take more time, because in the back end it will update all the statistics. So here we can see that it is now the interim patch, that is this patch is OJVM patch is successfully updated, and even though 19.12 release update is installed successfully. So that means it is from 19.11 to 19.12 release update is successfully done. And so all the alerts log, you can see this is data. This data will be basically getting updated, and even though it will reflect on the standby also. So as soon as this data patch verbose gets completed, we'll be verifying all the details that we have previously captured. So before start of the patching, we have captured all these details. So we will basically provide all information like what is the current version and what is the current values for different components and everything. Okay, so I hope you guys have understood how to upgrade any existing 19.11 version to 19.12. This is so simple and easy to follow. Basically we have to do the patching. In our case, we have patched standby environment first, then after that I patched the production database environment. So it's basically even though you can do the primary setup patching first and then the later standby patching setup patchings, but it is up to you which method you want to do. But as a best practice, you should always do the patching on the standby first and then the primary side later. Okay. So now my data patch verbose is successfully completed. Here we can see that all these steps are completed and there is no log. So what I'll do, I'll just log into the database and verify other details. So my both the database instances are up and running. Next part, I'll be verifying all the other steps. So here we can see this is apply RU is successfully completed and the patch is applied from 19.11 to 19.12. That means it is upgraded successfully. Even though I have applied the OGVM patches on this system. So these steps are successfully completed. And even though we can cross verify these details on standby also. So let me log in there. Here also it is reflecting. That means we have successfully completed this entire database upgradation process. So I hope you have understood how to perform the database upgrade from the 19.11 to 19.12. If you have any question, you can send me an email. And again, thanks for watching this video. Have a great day. If you have any queries, send me an email. I'll definitely try to help you out. And please watch other videos, like this video and share across your colleagues. Have a great day. Bye.